Yeah, good afternoon everybody, or good day everybody. It's good to be live with you all today. I'm glad that we are connected to share together from today's weekend talk. MAC Oladejo is my name. I'm the lead pastor of the Lord's Portion Restorers Church at Opik in Lagos, Nigeria. I'd like to appreciate all of our friends and loved ones that have always connected with us online. I'd like to appreciate all of you. And at the same time, I like to condone with families that have lost their loved ones, their children, their sons, their daughters, in the course of the recent happening in Nigeria. I like to condone with you. I like to identify with your pains. It could be very, very painful to lose or to have to lose your loved ones, especially when they are your children, that are our future. Our children are our future. So I want to condone with those that had had to lose their sons or their daughters in the past few weeks. I want to pray that God will console you. I'm praying that God will energize you so that you can face the challenges of the time. I like to also identify with the pains of some of our people that have also lost properties, that have lost investment, you know, to this protest. A number of people have lost investment, and I like to just identify with them. Number of people have lost their businesses, you know, into this past protest. So I'd like to just also identify with your pains, and I pray that God will make you rise again. Yes, it is true that the protest was hijacked by hoodlums, right? And hoodlums that have had to boggle your stores, boggle your businesses, and destroying properties. Would like to identify with all of you. I also want to use this time to appreciate the youths. I want to appreciate the youths who have sincerely struggled and have protested in the past few weeks. All of our youths that have had to protest in the past few weeks, you know, for the government's attention on their concerns. We appreciate you all, and I would like to say as a pastor that I know your pains, I identify with your pains, and I believe that God is going to touch the hearts of our government so that these are our concerns are taken care of, right? And let me use this time to dedicate this session of Weekend Tonic. I'd like to dedicate it to the youths, especially those ones that lost their lives, those ones that also lost their properties. I'd like to dedicate this Weekend Tonic session to them all. No, I'm dedicating it to them all. I pray that our Father will show you His might and His power in giving you a recall. That's my prayer for you. That's why I'm dedicating this Weekend Tonic to those people. May posterity and history reward you and reward your labors and your sacrifice. Amen. Yes, for everyone that have had to join me today, I'd like you to please keep connected as we share together within these few minutes in this weekend tonic. Thank you very much, my brother. It's a long time, bro. Bro, Deolu, it's a long time. Good to connect with you today. All right, let us pray before we move ahead. Father, we want to thank you for all the challenges that we've had to face in the past few weeks. Thank you for our nation, Nigeria. Thank you for what you have already started. Thank you for what you're doing. And so as we share together today, I pray that you're going to give us guide and instructions by your spirit, that we'll understand, Lord, the times and the seasons, like the children of Issachar. Speak as we listen and share together in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. So today we are sharing what I call lose it, gain it. Lose it, gain it. Gaining has little or no meaning when you have not recorded any loss. Gaining has little or no meaning when you have no record of loss or losses. Most of the times we want to gain, but we don't emotionally prepare for loss. And that's what I've realized with us. You know, we want to gain, but we're not ready to record losses. But it doesn't work like that, right? Counting losses sometimes has the capacity to bring great gains. And that's what I want to share with you today. When you count your losses, it is true. Yeah, the Bible says we should count our blessings. Name them one by one. And it will surprise you what the Lord had done. But if you want to experience what the Lord will do, sometimes you may need to count your losses. Sometimes. It's not to say that God will not bring gain without you losing. No. But we're saying that it's essential for you and I to be emotionally ready, to be emotionally prepared, that when we are going on the pursuit of gains, we must be, you know, we must have this ready shock absorber, in case losses comes, in case we lose something. And that's why, you know, the loss will not meet us, you know, abruptly. It wouldn't meet us in a shock. A number of people have had to lose things. I remember in those days when people used to, you know, stock their money in stock exchange, in the stock market. You know, I remember that time when there was a crash. I know a number of people that crashed with it. I know a number of people that lost their lives. I know a number of people that were paralyzed, right? The issue is that we don't always prepare emotionally for the shock of loss when we're on the pursuit of gains. We only look at what we want to gain, you know, and we don't prepare for the loss. You know, so this is why when we are hit with the blows of losses, you know, it staggers us. It staggers us, and sometimes it gets some people down to never rise again. You know, so that's why I want to just share with you today that, you know, gain has a part of it that first, you know, that is always first heralded, you know, before the gain comes, and that is loss. You know, so when we are emotionally prepared for it, it wouldn't stagger us. It wouldn't take us, you know, on our ways. It would meet a shock in us, and we are able to bounce back, you know, suddenly, and we are able to bounce back into the gains, you know, that might probably be waiting for us ahead of the days. All right, so our topic we're sharing is lose it, gain it. Let me just refer us to a text of the scriptures, you know, a text of the scriptures, Matthew chapter 16, verse 25. Matthew 16:25. Jesus was the one talking there, and Jesus said, Whoever wants to save his own life, whoever wants to save his own life will lose it. And whoever loses his life will gain. Whosoever loses his life will gain. And so Jesus had, you know, used these words to prepare us, on the journey of gains. There is no gain without losses. It's not to say that you have to lose, but that is what life holds. You must just understand that that is just it about life, right? So you must be emotionally prepared. And so I'm not also saying that we should pray that losses should come. No, I'm not saying that we should pray that anyone will lose anything, either animate or inanimate. But the truth be told, loss is part of life. Or losing something is part of life. It's part of the journey of gains in life. And that's why Jesus said it. He said, if you lose your life, in fact, he didn't even say that if you lose something. He said, if you lose your life, so to the extent of him saying your life, my life, if it is lost for the sake of him, he said, we're going to gain it. Right. So on this basis, I want to share with us, you know, especially for the critical seasons we are in now. You know, in the last few weeks, many people have had to record the number of losses. In the last few months, in fact, this year generally has been a year of turbulence and losses, right? But I want us to be very positive. That's why we come up with some of these topics, so that we become very positive. We can still gain. The year is not still over. You might have lost some things in the past few weeks. You might have even lost your loved ones, like we have condoned, you know, as we started with those that have had to lose their loved ones, you know. But it is a path of gain. You must understand that it is also the path of gain. Yeah. And these are the things I like to share with us today, right? I don't pray that anyone loses anything. I don't pray to lose. But I'm trying to say that let's be emotionally, you know, ready always. When we're on the journey of gains, let's be prepared. Have that shock absorber in case losses comes. And that's why Jesus said, whoever wants to save his own life will lose it. But whoever loses it will gain it. So it's better to lose and gain. It's better to lose and gain than to try to save something without planning for the losses, right? And that's what Jesus is saying here. So how do we lose to gain? And that's what I want to critically share with us today. How do we lose to gain? How would our losses not just be losses, but will later turn to gains? Let me just share this with you today, very quickly. How do we lose to gain? Number one, it is when you path with something temporarily, sometimes permanently. But when you are able to part with something temporarily, you know, so that you can get it in the nearest future. When you part away with something with the expectation that you will get it in some nearest future, that is loss that brings gain. Parting with something. Jesus lost his throne. Jesus lost his throne. He was seated in glory with God in the heavenly places, but he lost his throne so that he can come die for you and I. So that was a loss. He parted with that in the bid to gain you and I. So he had to part with something. He parted with his throne to be here on earth so that he can gain back you and I unto God. So when you lose anything or you part anything with the readiness to get it back in some nearest future. That is loss for gains. That is loss for gains, you know. But Jesus, you know, said it. He said, if you lose your life for a good purpose, that's why, you know, I'm still coming to that. That's why your losses must be purposeful. If you're going to part with anything, it must be purposeful. I'm going to come to that very soon. Number two, how do you lose to gain? You lose to gain when you fail forward. You lose to gain when you fail forward. Several times when we are failing or when we are falling, we fall backward. We fail backward. But you see, you lose to gain when you fail, but your failure is failing forward. Failing forward. I remember I read the book some time ago. It should still be in my library at home. If I search my library very well, I love that book. It talks about failing forward. Failing forward. You know, so failing certainly is a type of loss. When you fail, it is a type of loss that has the potential for gains. Failing has potential for pain, for gains, right? So if the failure, it will have the potential for gain if only the failure is failing forward. If it is not failing backward. When you fail backward, it has no gain in it. When you fail and you fail, you fail and you just stay there, it has no gain in it. But when you fail forward, it has been a gain, right? So your losses will become very gainful when you fail forward. Failing forward is to fail and keep rising. You fail and you keep rising. You fail, you rise again. The Bible says in Micah chapter 7, Micah 7 verse 8, the Bible says there, it says, do not rejoice over me, my enemy. When I fall, I will rise. That is failing forward. That is someone that is failing forward. Don't rejoice over me. When I fall, I know I will rise. Right? But someone that falls without making effort to rise again, the person has failed backward. The person has fallen backward. Right? So, when you are losing to gain, it is for you to fail forward. That is it. Fail forward. There is hope for a tree. That's what the Bible says. There is hope for a tree that is cut down at the scent of water. The Bible says it will rise again. You know, I was watching the case of a woman, one Mrs. Adeyemi or so. I was watching, you know, her own story. She's part of those that lost some things in the malls, you know, in the shop rights. She lost things in millions. She said she lost things in millions. I know I'm coming back stronger. I'm coming back better. Yeah, that is someone that is feeling forward. So she has recorded losses, but her losses, she is seeing gain ahead. So feeling forward is a sort of losing to gain. Number three, when you lose it to gain it, what do we mean? We are saying that it is to sacrifice something there. Sacrificing something there because you want to have it back. Right? Allowing something to go or to die. You know, you allow something to die, you sacrifice it, you let it go. That is when you are losing to gain. Let something die so that you can harvest it. Right? I've never seen a farmer who expects gains in the nearest future and will not sow and expect the seed to die. You know, like I said, I condone with those that have had to lose loved ones. But one thing we don't understand most times is that there is no protest anywhere in the world. Look at that of Martin Luther King. He lost his life. We really identify to those that lost their lives. But we must understand there is no gain without sacrifices of loss. But sometimes the sacrifices come by the shedding of blood. Jesus had to shed his blood so that he can gain us. It's unfortunate for those that their blood was shed. We don't know whose blood will be shed. But we want to see them. And that's why we are seeing them, in fact, as heroes. Why? Because their blood was sacrificed on the altar of gains for Nigeria. Their blood were sacrificed so that Nigeria can gain. Wow! What a sacrifice. What a sacrifice. But you see, usually we are not emotionally prepared for it. It's always painful when it comes. But that is the reality of life. Some people may have to be sacrificed. Some people may part and may have to sacrifice their ones, their things for a gain. You're right. So when you are losing and it will be a loss for gain, it must be sacrifices with expectation of having it come back. Right? It is in death of seeds that lies the gainful harvest of an harvest of a farmer. It is in the death of the seed lies the gainful harvest of a farmer. And so when there is death, it is expected that the seed that dies is the seed that will bring harvestful gains. Right? So we must be ready, looking at our losses in this direction. Now, even when things die, we can see them come to life again. That is when you are losing it to gain it. And number three, when losses can be categorized as gainful loss. Number four, it is to cast your bread upon the waters. When you are casting your bread upon the water, it is a loss. But the Bible says, after some days, it will come back. Cast your bread. Loss that will bring gain is the loss that are like as if you are casting something upon the waters. You know, when you cast bread upon water, you know it will swell. But it could be painful to cast the bread. It could be very painful to cast the bread. But the Bible says, cast your bread upon the waters, and after many days, it will come back. Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verse 1. After many days, it will have swollen. Then you will have gain. Because after many days, it will surely come back. And that is it. When we are talking about lossful, gainful losses. When we're talking about gainful losses, it is in casting bread with expectation that after many days, and sometimes it may not be days, it may be weeks. Sometimes it may not be weeks, it may be months. And sometimes it may be in years. But when you cast your bread upon the waters, the living water especially, when you cast it upon the living water, obviously, it will come to you. It returns to you swollen. And that's when you will have bumper. They call it bumper harvest. Bumper harvest. But most of the times, we are not prepared to cast anything. We're not prepared to cast it. And fifthly, when you count the cost. I'm talking about how to lose to gain. When you count the cost. Underline the critical word there, cost. Cost can be converted to cash or money. Most of the times we want to have our money. We don't want to cast it. We don't want to lose it. Right? Sometimes you want to see your money in the bank, and you'll just be seeing your alert and you'll be happy, you'll be glad. But if you want to gain more, cast it. If you want to gain more, he who wants to build a tower must first sit down and count the cost. To have a tower is gain. But the cost, you have to let go the cost. That money you see in your bank account, you have billions, you have millions, but you need a tower. You want to get a tour and say, I'm the owner of that tour. You know, there's something they call, you know, Trump tour in the US. United States of America president, he has a tour. You know, but if he has not casted money, he wouldn't get the tour. And that's why the Bible says in Luke chapter 14, verse 28, the Bible says, anyone that will build a tower must first sit down and count the cost and be ready to part away with the cost. Be ready to give away and sacrifice the money. Then you will see the tower. So you can't have the tower when you still have the money. And that's why English people will say you can't have your cake and eat it. Yeah, they say it. You can't eat your cake and have it. Right? So that is the cost. Count the cost. If you want to lose to gain, count the cost. Count the cost. If you want to see a tower rising up, count the cost. Lose the cost first. Lose that money. Then you will gain the tower. That is the meaning. And sixthly, it is to be denied of a demand. When you are going to gain by recording losses, to lose there means that you have to be denied. Be ready to be denied of your demands. Yeah, we all were disappointed when the president read what he wanted to read to us. We all were disappointed. To some people, it's a denial. But we must not see it as a denial. We must not see it as a denial. If we're going to gain eventually, we must see it as the call to re-strategize. We must see it as the need to sit back and think on other approaches that would also be peaceful in getting the gains we want. Yeah, that's it. That's it. That's how to make sure that your losses turn around to be gains. So that you won't just lose and lose forever. You know, that's it. You know, what we mostly lose sometimes. Two things. We mostly lose two things. Number one, animate things. We lose animate things. Most of the time when we need to gain, we may need to lose animate things. Properties, you know. Properties, just animate things. You lose properties. I mean, some people have lost properties. You know, lose things around you. You know, but make sure if it's going to bring gain, make sure, you know, you can either lose it deliberately or accidentally. There are two ways to lose. Deliberately. If you are losing anything deliberately because you want to gain, let it be purposeful. Let it be very purposeful. And that's why Jesus said, you know, in the text we read, you know, in Matthew 16, Jesus said, whoever wants to save his own life will lose it. But whoever loses it will gain it. There must be a purpose. If you have to lose your property, lose your thing so that you can gain something, lose it on purpose. Right? Lose it on purpose. That is when the loss is deliberate so that you can gain. Let it be very purposeful. Let your loss target towards something so that it will turn into gain for you. But if you are deliberately losing something, without gain, that's foolishness. Right? And second way to lose something, or second way of what we lose, is we lose things accidentally. If you have had to lose things accidentally, then you must trust God to rise again. That's just the way out for the game. Trust God to rise again. If your loss is accidental, trust God to rise again. Like that woman. You know, she said, I'm coming back, I'm bouncing back. That is resilience. That is resilience. And you must have that resilience if you have accidental loss. and it must turn around to gain, then trust God. Trust God to rise again. Trust God to get it back. Trust God that these accidental laws will not knock you down. Finally. Right? And sometimes also, when we are recording our losses, we record inanimate losses. We record inanimate losses. And that could be very sad. That is when we lose lives. Right? We lose living things. We lose our beloved people. You know? However, these are the two ways we mostly lose things. You know? Or these are the major two things we lose. Animate things or inanimate things. And so, if you are losing inanimate things, and have I missed it together? You are missing animate things is when you are missing something that is living, something that has life. That's animate, something that has life. If you have to lose something that has life, then you must make sure that it is deliberate or accidental. How do you go about it? If it is deliberate, it must be purposeful. It must be purposeful. If it is accidental, then don't let it happen unless you have connected, you know, and you have encountered Christ. If you are losing animate things, living things. But if you are losing inanimate things, sorry to mix it up. If you are losing inanimate things, then that is when you must know. I mean, those are properties. Yeah, those are properties. And that is when you must know that you have to rise. If it is accidental. But if it is deliberate that you have to lose it, then know that it must be lost for a purpose. In all, I will just summarize by saying that to gain, be ready to lose. To gain, be ready to lose. But if there is anything you must lose ever, lose your life in Christ. Lose your life in Christ, because that's where you can gain it. But if you just lose your life without a purpose in Christ, and that is where the danger is, and that is where one will be losing without any gain, without any gain. So if you're going to lose anything deliberately, let it be purposeful. If you're going to lose your life also, let it be a loss in Christ. And when you have a loss, when you have lost your life because of Christ or in Christ, you will gain it, obviously. And when you have lost anything that is property, you can also gain it when you believe that when you fall, you rise again. When you fall and fail forward, then it becomes very gainful to lose anything. I pray, it's my prayer, that this season we will lose no more. We have lost, enough is enough. The remaining part of this year, I pray that no one will lose anything. People have lost their businesses, people have lost their jobs, you know, people have lost promising careers. But I pray that you will lose no more. We have lost lives. It's very painful. But I pray we will lose no more. However, in all of these losses, let's make sure that we focus on the gains that are thereafter. When we focus on the gains that are thereafter, that is when our fall will mean nothing to us, but to be very purposeful when we fall. We know that we're going to rise again, and we'll make effort to also move forward and tenaciously carry on rising. It's good to have to share with you in this tonic today. I want to thank you for joining me as we have shared together. I appreciate all of you that have had to join today. I pray that God will bless you. Tomorrow is Sabbath. Yeah, there is lockdown, you know, partial lockdown. It says 8 a.m. People must move around 8 a.m. So it means the service is going to start for 9:30 tomorrow. I look forward that we continue as you join me when we continue on the topic we call the topic. That is just a topic for tomorrow, the topic. Let's connect together. And as much as you can be in church, let's be in church. Go to your place of worship. Worship God with all your heart. Remember, sacrifices are required for every gain. We need to make sacrifices at this time so that we can gain in God and gain God on our side. He will fight for us. Nigeria will rise again. Nigeria will not fall and fall and remain falling. Nigeria will rise again. You will fall, but you will rise also. You will not fall and fall perpetually, because there is gain in every loss and there is gain in every fall. I look forward that we connect together tomorrow. God bless you. Again, MC Oladejo is my name, a senior pastor and lead pastor of the Lord's Portion Restorers Church, OPIC. Thank you for joining me today. God bless you, and I wish you a wonderful weekend. Stay blessed and stay safe. Always.